I'd like to record a video today and talk about the spirit of error and also make a testimony about hell. Jesus Christ promised His Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth, to guide us into all truth. I mean, Christians who are following Jesus, who obey His words in the Bible and the four Gospels, and who stopped sinning and who follow Jesus, they have the Spirit of Truth who guides them into all truth. But there is also the spirit of error, which guides worldly people. The main spirit which guides worldly people is spirit of error. And spirit of error is something like when you sincerely believe that something is like this when it's not, but it very much seems to you that it is so. For example, you know, many worldly people, they believe that the meaning of life is to prosper financially and to be successful in the world, and that the more money you get, the better it is, and that this is the meaning of life, to enjoy life and to be prosperous, that this is like happiness, this is the meaning of life. But it is not so, because Jesus showed us that the meaning of life is sacrificial love. Meaning of life is to follow Jesus Christ. He Himself is the meaning of life, and He showed us the way. His way is sacrificial love. He died for us, and Christian way is living holy, righteously, godly, and sacrificially, helping the poor, the needy, the animals, you know, because the meaning of life is sacrificial love. This is true love. Error is this worldly spirit which guides people not to help the poor or to help them a little bit, which guides them not to fast, not to bring their body as a sacrifice to the Holy Spirit so He may use them and sanctify them and dwell in them more. And today I'd like to share also a testimony about hell. In 2015, Jesus Christ visited me after a strong chastisement which He made to me for not helping the poor enough. And after I was chastised severely for 11 months, after my birthday, Jesus came to me and stopped chastisement. And He showed me that the way of my Christianity before that was a way to hell. I was a Christian who was preaching holiness. Holiness is the true teaching, as Jesus, when He came here, explained to me that true Christianity is holiness or hell. Those who preach this are, in general, preaching the right way. But, so you understand, worldly Christianity is totally lost. It's totally in spirit of error, because they are not preaching holiness. They are not preaching Christian lifestyle, which it really is, you know, helping the poor and living holy. And those people who preach holiness, in general, that's the true Christian teaching, holiness or hell. But even among those preachers, most preachers have a way and preach a way with a huge error. And for that error, they can still end up in hell. And the error which those preachers preach is not helping the poor enough, not fasting enough, not doing works for humility and for sanctification of your soul, or doing them in a little measure. That's the majority among those holiness preachers. And many of them, many, are on the way to hell. And me, myself, I was the same way. I was street preaching and going out and preached holiness or hell. I was preaching on YouTube, and I thought I was doing very well. But after that, for example, I came home after street preaching and I ate pork legs and pizza another day. Third day I was eating like beef steaks and tasty food every day. You know, I wasn't overweight. But I ate it every day, tasty food, three times a day, you know, pizzas, not always like luxury foods, sausages, fried eggs, but all the time. Then I was like maybe fasting one day a week, And then again, I was preaching holiness. I thought I was living holy. I stopped sinning. I stopped practicing willful sins, you know, and lust and all kinds of those sins, you know, masturbation, you know. I overcame all that and sleeping with other women. I overcame all that and I stopped. And I thought that now I'm going to heaven. And now only Holy Spirit guides me. But reality is not only Holy Spirit guided me, but spirit of error also, because spirit of error has effect when you're not really working on humility. There is space for pride, and pride births wickedness, you know, frowardness, wickedness. And a spirit of error comes when you have wickedness in heart. It is wicked in heart to eat tasty food every day, because you are spending too much money on yourself. That's number one. Second is when you eat tasty food every day, it births pride, you know, it births pride in your feelings and heart. And for pride come deceptions. Also, when you're fed up with food, all extra food that you eat that you do not really need, it goes into passions, into malice, into evil thoughts, into enmity, into lust, into anger and irritation, into being spiritually lazy and spiritually weak, because it makes the heart weak, as Jesus said, that watch out that your hearts will not be overburdened with food and drink, that the day will catch you unaware. Because tasty food, even when you're not a glutton, but eat tasty food every day, your heart is burdened, and you're acting wickedly towards Jesus. When people do not fast enough, when they eat tasty food every day, you know, they do not bring their body as a sacrifice to Holy Spirit. And they do not have enough Holy Spirit, because Jesus gives Holy Spirit to the humble. Humility is not only in the mind, but in heart. To be humble, you not only have to think lowly about yourself, to do self-reproving, I speak about it in other videos, but you have to do works for humility. You have to fast. You should make days when you eat strict food, and not every day you eat tasty food, and you eat it in moderation. Prayers on the knees also give humility. Vigils. Most Christians are not doing this, or doing this in a very little measure, and they're not bringing their body as a sacrifice to Holy Spirit. And they're under big influence of two spirits, spirit of error and spirit of deception. When Jesus visited me, he also showed me places in hell where he could send me. And there is a hell, and there are places which are called dark realities. Or I'm not sure which the word is in English, because I know this word in Russian, but it's kind of like dark realities or gloomy realities or murky realities. I'm not sure which is the best translation, but I'll call them dark realities. The difference is that dark reality is something like hell. It's a hellish world, but it looks more like this world, but like a dark fairy tale. For example, he explained to me that for serious sins, he sends people right into hell. It's places with lava, and like they look like caves, dark caves with lava and very scary. And for less grave sins, he sends them to these dark realities or murky realities. I'm not sure which is the right translation. He showed me places when he visited me in hell and in murky realities, in these dark realities, where he could send me for my sins. And my sins were unwillful. I stopped willfully sinning. But for example, he showed me the place. Now I'm walking in the forest, and he showed me a murky reality which looked pretty much like this, but I don't know, 100 times maybe more scary than this, because now it's daytime, it's bright, and I'm in a forest, and it's not very dense. But there, the forest looked, it was very, very dark night, and the forest looked dark greenish, you know, and like in a scary, scary fairy tale. And people, if you get there, you are walking in this forest and you cannot get out. It's a punishment for the spirit of error. It's like you're lost. You lost your way, because Jesus is the truth and the life and the way. He said, I'm the way, the truth, the life. So you lost the way. You do not love the way too much. That's why you're given over to error. You don't love the truth too much. You're given over to error. That it seems to you like it's truth, but it's not truth. That was the case with me with food. I was not also helping the poor enough. And it's very important to Jesus. That's number one. But people who usually do not fast enough, they usually do not help the poor enough, because often food is connected with greed and with fear. Because when you eat too much, you get pride. Pride makes you fearful, because you have less light of Holy Spirit with you. When you're fearful, you fear to help the poor, because you fear that it will not be enough for you, you know, or for something, and you do not trust God enough. So that's all connected, and it's all not sacrificial lifestyle. That's an error. When you love yourself too much, like people of the world, for them the meaning of life is to enjoy life to the fullest, you know, to love yourself. Jesus said to deny yourself, to pick up your cross and follow him. So that was one of my errors. Another error which I had is I had televisions in my apartment where I live, and I wasn't watching them much back then, but my family members were watching it, and so I thought it's okay to have a TV. I didn't watch them much, maybe news a little bit, but Jesus showed me he could send me to hell for these televisions at my home, because he hates televisions with a passion, because people sit in front of those TVs and they get permeated by all the filth which comes from the television, and he sends to hell for this. And in hell they put people inside of walls for televisions, you know, because people like to sit in front of those televisions like glued and take in all this garbage which comes from there, you know. And Jesus said, if your eye is dark, what will be with your body? If the light in you is darkness, what is your darkness? You know, many people, Christians, believe it's okay, TV is okay. No, it's not okay, it's evil. You have to guard yourself, and it's huge error for which Jesus sends many Christians to hell. And he could send me both to the forest and into the walls, you know, to be stuck in those walls, to be closed inside of hell's walls for this sin, because Jesus showed me that in hell you do not sit in one place. You're taken from place to place, from a murky reality. I don't know, maybe they take you to hell underground, I mean, where there are caves and lava. If you have more serious sins, for lesser sins, you're in murky realities, and you're rotated like this all the time there. And another thing which I forgot to mention, that in this hellish place, in this dark reality or murky reality, it's not only you just walk, as far as understood, in those forests and can't get out, in this terrible, dark, gloomy forest at night, but demons beat you up there. So it's all terrible, you know, and you cannot get out. And I was so scared that I threw away three of my televisions, you know. I threw them away to the garbage. And you should do the same also if you want to get saved. And Jesus warned me to preach especially to Christians, that they, and to warn them that they are not living sacrificial lifestyle. They're not living holy, righteous. And those who preach holiness and live holiness, usually their error is they neglect fasts. They even, many do not know what a vigil is. They neglect all these works for humility. Many of them do not even know about them. Like I was, you know, I was fasting maybe one day a week, and then I was eating every day tasty foods, three times a day. And thought it's okay, it's not a sin, I'm not overweight, you know, I'm fasting one day a week, you know, so what, you know. And I had televisions in my home, and though I preached holiness and lived holiness, but it wasn't good enough for Jesus. And many Christians are under the influence of this spirit, and for that they can end up in woods, in those terrible places, dark reality, this wood place. This what I said to you now is sure, it's my testimony, it's what Jesus showed to me when he visited me. He showed me places in hell, in murky realities or these dark realities where he could send me for my sins. And so I warn others, especially Christians. And now what I'm going to say to you is my guess. I'm not sure about this. Is this that I'm thinking that maybe this is why worldly people decorate Christmas trees on Christmas and on New Year, because maybe there is worship to this spirit of error like this, because you get sent into forest for error, which is full of these Christmas trees, you know, these trees and Christmas trees. And so maybe this is why the world decorates a Christmas tree on New Year and on Christmas, because they're worshiping instead of Jesus, the spirit of error, which leads them into such places, you know, in this murky reality with this forest. So they are lost. They do not love the truth, and they are lost in these woods, in these forests. And they do not love the way, who is Jesus Christ. They lost their way. So, but this is my guess. I will tell you sincerely, I do not have revelation from Jesus about this. It's not revealed to me. It's my guess. I could be wrong. And I know that pagans used to make sacrifices, human sacrifices, under Christmas trees to pagan demons, you know. But still, why they use the Christmas tree? Why they use the tree of such form? Maybe because it's worship to this spirit of error, which leads all worldly people and most Christians today. Worship, and they put on these Christmas trees presents and golden balls, you know, because they worship in the spirit of prosperity, the spirit of egotism, not the sacrificial love of Jesus, which is opposite. They worship this prosperity to get rich, to get wealthy, you know. It's all about egotism and materialism. That's the world's spirit of error, which could guide them into this. Christians today do not like this message because they think it's religion, it's not needed, you know, fasting and what is this, you know. But if you look at Jesus, Jesus was a great ascetic. He fasted for 40 days. You know, Moses fasted 40 days and even more, I think. And all prophets who wrote the Bible were great ascetics and men of great faith. And early church fathers were all great ascetics. And so if Bible is written by great ascetics, prophets and apostles, apostles were all great ascetics. And the Christians today say, oh, well, we don't need fasting, you know, it's religion, you know. Really? It's okay when Christians come to Jesus Christ and they start out with small things. But when Christians are following Jesus like for 3-5 years, and they do not know what a vigil is, you know, it was like me, you know, or they do a little fasting, you know, that's error, and it leads them unto deceptions, because you will constantly be deceived. If you do not bring your body as a sacrifice to Jesus Christ, if you do not do works for humility, combined with lowliness in your mind, with self-reproving, with lowly thinking about yourself, you know, you should do all these works, not to get spiritually rich, but you're trying to get out of the ditch, you know, to get saved into furthest corner of heaven. And you're doing it to make space for Holy Spirit, so He comes into you and guides you and leads you. And I talk about this in other videos. You know, if you do not want that, you will always be deceived by your flesh. You know, Christians who are lazy, spiritually lazy, who do not do those works for humility, they are almost always deceived, and you cannot even listen to what they say, you know, their revelations, you know, what God revealed to them, because it's almost always like 95% error and deception, because they start off with wickedness to God, you know. They come to God wickedly, they do not bring their body as a sacrifice to Holy Spirit. God gives the Holy Spirit, Spirit of Truth, to the humble. Humility requires lowliness in your mind and works for your heart, you know, because pride can be in your mind and in your heart. In mind there are thoughts, in heart there are feelings, and there is your will. So only when it's combined you have humility, and only then you have the fullness of experience of what humility is, you start to grow in it, and then you grow in it all your life, and Holy Spirit grows in you. The Church Fathers taught that the measure of a person in Christ is how much humble he is. Not what he does, but how humble he is, I mean, with works for humility and with lowly thinking combined. Because I told in my other videos, I myself am not a great ascetic. I live on a very moderate rule of life, and I tried a bigger rule of life before, but it brought me to pride and to murmuring, and that also leads to hell. There are two extremes. One extreme is being spiritually lazy and not doing anything or doing a little bit. That's most Christians what they do. It leads to hell. Another way, which is extreme, which is bad, it's more for serious Christians who overdo it because of pride, because they want to be great in faith, because they think it's zealous and zeal, you know, and they should be zealous and fast like Jesus, you know, or fast like apostles, or even like middle Christians who are, like, I don't know, 20, 30 years in Christ with ascetic work, you know. And that leads to high pride and to deception, and that leads to murmuring, because it will be too hard. You do not have enough love in you to endure that. You do not have enough grace to endure that. You will be irritated towards God, and you will end up in hell, or can end up in hell. So both ways are perilous, you know. What you need to do is, I'm not gonna set a rule of life for you, but you gotta seek Jesus, because all people are very different on how much to fast, how much to do vigils every week, you know, how much you should fast every week. You should also make days with some strict food, not eat tasty food every day, you know. You set some days where you eat bread and water, or like toasted bread with water. Toasted bread, I mean gray bread, which doesn't have sugar. That's what early church fathers ate. And do not eat three times a day, every day. Eat two times a day, every day. That's what early church fathers ate. Two times a day, bread and water. And I'm not saying that you have to eat bread and water every day, you know, but do not eat three times a day. That's my advice, to eat two times a day, every day, even when you're not fasting and not having strict food day. Eat two times a day. Take some days a week, as Jesus, how many, for bread and water. Some days you can eat lentils or special type of wheat. I will write their names below. You can eat them together, or just lentils, or this some type of wheat. And I want to add something else, that eating two times a day instead of three times a day is not just my recommendation, it's what early church fathers did. Some of them, they ate two times a day. Some of them ate one time a day. Some of them ate once in few days. But those were perfect men, great men in faith, perfect men, and perfect in virtues. And you can forget about it, you know, eating once in a few days. They didn't need much food, because they were fed by the grace of God. They supernaturally were sustained and fed by the Holy Spirit. But that's only for perfect men, and they were very humble. But again, as I said, you can forget about it. It's for perfect men in virtues. And also remember that those people who are doing this, like eating once in a few days, they built themselves up to it for all their life, you know, gradually. There are two bad extremes. One is people are spiritually lazy and doing nothing or very little because of their wickedness. They say, I'm weak in faith, you know, I cannot do this and I cannot do that. Thinking that you're weak in faith is good, but thinking that you're weak in faith with wickedness is evil. When you say such things and you do not nothing or very little, you will be in constant deception. And people who are lazy in fasts and vigils, you know, they are usually always under deception. People who overdo it are also under deception, but it's a more rare case. And also, I want to say that as you think about yourself, that way Jesus guides you. If you think of yourself that you're weak in faith, weak spiritually, without wickedness, but truthfully, Jesus will guide you truthfully. but if you think that you're great in faith, that you're big in the kingdom of God, important, fear adds up to Jesus' guidance, and he will guide you into extreme works, in fasts, in vigils, in preaching, and you will become a murmurer. You will be irritated against God, and you can end up in hell. Or even if you do not end up in hell, you will regret for all eternity. There is huge value to moderation in spiritual walk. But for majority of Christians, that other extreme of overdoing it, it's not even visible. They are far away from it. Most of them are so lazy. And I was myself like that, and I tried both extremes. Both are perilous. Seek Jesus on good measure, on right guidance, but seek him with pure heart. Think about yourself correctly, that you are little in the kingdom of God, that you are weak in faith, but without wickedness, that you want to do everything which needs to be done according to your measure without wickedness. You don't want to be lazy, you want to be zealous, but like a little creature in the kingdom of God, like a little person. As Jesus taught me to think about myself, that I'm a little guinea pig in his kingdom, with holy humor. I'm not going to say much about this in this video. I talk about this in my other videos. You can watch them about strict food. But this will help you to make room for Holy Spirit. This will help you to get more of Holy Spirit. So you will not be in deception, you will not be in error, and you will learn to be guided by Jesus' language of understanding. That's how Jesus Christ guides people. And I'm not saying that you cannot eat tasty food, you know. I myself, I'm living on a moderate rule of life, and there are days every week when I eat tasty food, but you should do it in moderation, you know. And you know, as I said in my other videos, I eat pizza, I eat, well, pretty much everything which I like, you know, but in moderation. And you should also eat two times a day, not three. It's very vital to help the poor and the animals enough, because this is the meaning of life. So I urge you to take this word seriously, because I know through my Russian YouTube channel, through the statistics there, that most Christians do not really like the message about fasts, vigils, you know, helping the poor, because I know that when I preach messages which have less of this content, the videos have more, so to say, popularity. But I'm not speaking it because I want to be popular. I want my message to be effective. But when I start to preach about fasts and vigils, you know, and alms, those videos have less popularity, because Christians, from that I know that most Christians are very lazy, very spiritually lazy, and they do not like this message because they are under the influence of this spirit. And I was under the influence of this spirit. It's because of wickedness of their heart, because they are not working on humility enough. Humility brings truth. Truth drives up out error and deception. When they're not doing it enough, they have this error, spirit of error, which guides them with the Holy Spirit. As Jesus explained to me later, he visited me four times, and on one of visits he explained to me more how this works. Where you're in truth, he guides you. Where you start to be wicked, in those areas where you start to be wicked, with the froward, God shows himself froward. It's written in the Psalms. He does like wickedness. This spirit is allowed to guide you in those areas. For example, as it was with me, I preached holiness, and Jesus guided me in my preaching and those things which I knew. But when it came to food, you know, I ignored the fine guidance of Holy Spirit in me, that do not eat such tasty food every day. Do not eat this so often. I ignored it, you know, and that was my wickedness. And for my wickedness, the spirit of error joined me and guided me into this error, which could lead me to hell. Same with TV, you know. Whoa, why throw them away? Yeah, I know Jesus doesn't like them. Well, I don't watch them much. Let them stay here. But Jesus showed me he could throw me into hell for that, you know. And I threw those TVs away. And I warn you and urge you, do not come to such places. This is like picnic compared to that which I saw. You know, it terrified me so much, I threw away 3 televisions to the garbage. If you're interested to watch my full testimony about how Jesus Christ visited me, I explained some other places in hell and in murky realities which Jesus showed me there. So I'm very serious about it, and I urge you to follow Jesus seriously. Come to Him with sincere heart about works for humility. Stop sinning, obey the commandments of Jesus in the 4 Gospels, and seek His guidance through Holy Spirit, through language of understanding. I made another video about it. It's called The Voice of God, where I explain how to do it, and maybe I'll do some more videos later about this issue. May Jesus bless you.